National Hot Rod Association. The Sports Nationals. By Fram, makers of oil, air, and fuel filters, windshield wipers, and Autolite spark plugs and tune-up kits. And by English Leather, toiletries for men. Ask for English Leather and find toiletry counters everywhere. And by Kodak, whose color burst instant cameras give you bright, brilliant, bursting color by Kodak. Chase Knight of Miami, Florida, hitting the wall at Beach Bend Park. Drag racing described as one of the quickest of all motorsports. It can go wrong just as quick. Let's look again as Chase Knight matches up against the defending champion, Jim Archer. You see him lose control right off the starting line, hits the wall, a glancing blow. The car not severely damaged, but if you'll take a close look, you'll notice the misalignment of the front wheels, the damage to the rear end, and also to the pocketbook of Chase Knight and partner Al Leiter. Here is the Grace Cup champion, Dale Armstrong, in the far side. He's matched against the funny car of Jerry Gwynn. Armstrong from California, Gwynn from Miami, Florida. This is first round racing. And again, one little error put the defending Grace Cup champion out of competition, giving the win to Jerry Gwynn. In slow motion, you see it happen right there as Dale Armstrong losing momentary control, the win going to Jerry Gwynn at over 205 miles an hour. Hello, everybody. I'm Dave McClelland, and this is the fifth annual Sports Nationals. We're in Beach Bend Park in Bowling Green, Kentucky, for the top of the line in sportsman category racing. Only the best from all over the United States and Canada make it to Beach Bend Park each year, for some 500 cars have been narrowed down to these final eliminator fields that we'll be seeing today. We'll be back with the start of racing in just a moment. Beach Bend Park and the Sports Nationals is Steve Evans. Steve will be bringing us all the background, the highlights of what goes on in this frantic activity called drag racing. Right now, before the start of racing, Steve's in the staging lanes.
Thank you very much, Dave. This race sure has a fun feeling to it. Guys and gals drag racing because they love it. Strictly sportsman racers. The first category of competition we're going to be seeing is Pro Comp. They are the quickest and fastest cars here at the Sports Nationals. There's dragsters, there's funny cars, and it's the only category that races heads up here today. Before we get to the Pro Comp action, let's meet some of the drivers.
Hi, I'm Ken Vini from Wadsworth, Ohio.
Hi, I'm Jim Archer from Los Alamos, New Mexico.
Hi. My name is Kenny Cook. I'm from Louisville, Kentucky.
Dale Armstrong, Torrance, California. I drive a AA dragster.
And we saw Dale Armstrong go down to defeat in first round racing in Pro Comp. This now marks the start of round number two in Pro Comp racing. Here's Ben Griffin driving the Carroll Brothers car from Dallas, Texas. Alongside of him, the funny car of Ken Vini. Quite a story behind this funny car, a brand new car, first time it's ever been down the racetrack, is here at the Sports Nationals. Pro Comp racing, a broad cross-section of cars, dragsters versus funny cars. The dragsters can be either supercharged or injected. Ben Griffin's car is injected, running on nitromethane. Ken Vini's funny car supercharged on alcohol. Leaving the line together, but Vini pulling a quick lead and holds on to the finish. 6.74 seconds and a new top speed record at 208 miles an hour for Ken Vini and his brand new funny car. Here in slow motion, we see Vini beginning to build up his lead in the last half of this race. And with a two-car length lead, gets to the finish line first. Two similar cars, Bill Wallace in the near lane. Wallace out of Middletown, Ohio. Willard Buff from Baytown, Texas. driving this Gold Digger entry, was the Pro Cop champion at the recent Cajun Nationals. You saw the action right here on Diamond P Sports. These two cars, very similar, alcohol-burning dragsters, supercharged engines, but running on alcohol. This is the top of the line in sportsman racing. We call it Pro Cop. And two of the best ready to go. Getting there first, but it's to no avail as back at the starting line, he left a big red light. Bill Wallace runs 6.82 seconds at over 202 miles an hour. Here in dramatic slow motion, you see just how it happened. Willard Buff in the far lane leaves just a hair too soon. As you see there, the red light comes on, and then the green for Bill Wallace. A pair of funny cars from London, Ontario, Canada, Frank Hawley, the Hawley family's entry, to be in the far lane. Gary Gwynn in the near lane knocked out the defending Grace Cup champion, Dale Armstrong, in round number one action. Gwynn from Miami having one of the best days of his long career. Both cars staging very carefully as they roll into the staging beams. They're actually light beams stretching across the starting line. Jerry Gwynn in the near lane, Frank Hawley in the far lane. Hawley now into his proper staging position. Here comes Jerry Gwynn. When they're set, the switch is thrown, and it's race time. Frank Hawley with lots of problems. Frank Hawley out of control and crosses right behind Jerry Gwynn. Gwynn rents the race, both to the finish line as Frank Hawley losing control, crossing the center line, which automatically disqualified him. Here in slow motion, we see it once again. Hawley's car making a violent move just as it leaves the starting line, moves right behind Jerry Gwynn in the same lane.
All right, here we go.
Let's go down now to Steve at the finish line area.
Jerry Gwynn of Miami, rather frightening race with Hawley, at least from our vantage point. I'm sure it was even scarier inside the car.
Yeah, he came over in my lane, but everything was under control.
Did you think there was a possibility of him hitting you?
Not really, no. I thought that we could get by each other all right.
How close was it?
Plenty close. I don't know how close it was.
Well, you're doing awfully well. In fact, the funny cars in general are doing well today when everybody says the dragster's a lot more consistent.
Yeah, that's true. There's going to be a funny car in the final, and I hope it's us.
Okay, so does your family here. Good luck.
All right. Thank you very much.
The final race of round number two in Pro Cop Eliminator, Cook and Thorne. This is Kenny Cook from Louisville, Kentucky. This is the defending champion here at the Sports Nationals. He comes from Los Alamos, New Mexico. That's Jim Archer. Archer's car is powered by one of the injected nitro-burning engines, while Kenny Cook, his car super light, using the small-block Chevrolet engine. The way the rules are written, allowing all types of engines and all types of fuel to be used in Pro Cop racing. The difference is the size of the engine, the weight of the car, and the type of the fuel used, which allows this very, very close racing in the heads-up category of Pro Cop. Graphic detail, we see those light beams across the track. Archer into the final beam and lead the line together. Something going wrong for Jim Archer. Kenny Cook with the lowest lap time of the day. 6.71 seconds, his speed 202 miles an hour. The defending champion out of it here at the Sports Nationals. Once again, let's go to the pits and Steve Evans.